A Long Beach couple is stuck paying for a multi-million dollar home and they can't even move in. The previous tenant refuses to leave.
And because of the county's eviction moratorium, he doesn't have to leave. CBS2's Christine Lazar has this bizarre story.
It was supposed to be their dream home, a multi-million dollar stunner right on the canal in Long Beach.
I love the house. I love the location. I love that we're going to be near family so they can help us with our three-year-old and five-year-old.
But that dream turned into a nightmare when the previous tenant refused to move out, telling the new owners of the property, Lori and Daniel Arche, that he does not intend to vacate the home until it becomes a legal requirement or until he chooses to do so on his own accord. The county's eviction moratorium doesn't expire until June 30th. The Arches closed on the house 3 months ago.
He knows he could hide behind the moratorium, and that's kind of where we are. We're stuck.
Since the couple closed on the home, they say the tenant continues to pay rent $7,000 a month, so they don't think finances are the reason that he won't go. A cash for keys offer of $30,000 was extended to the tenant, but he declined. Eviction attorney Melissa Marsh says the Arches cannot file a 60-day notice to evict until July 1st.
If they remain after that notice period, then they're probably looking at a solid 2 to 3 months to get it through the eviction courts at this time.
Marsh says once the house closes, there is no recourse, but that there are ways to get around the moratorium if the house is still in escrow.
And they've complied with the state laws alerting the tenant that the property is not subject to state rent control. You can technically remove the tenant.
The Arches are now contemplating selling their dream home because they fear retaliation, but they also worry no one would want to buy it with a stubborn tenant.
We just wanted to have a home for them to grow up and feel safe and have a lot of memorable memories there. So that's kind of all lost at this point.
In Long Beach, Christine Lazar, CBS 2 News.